Their first television appearance in the United States in 5 years. And as you know, they dominated the charts around the world, sold millions of records worldwide, and they're back to do it again.
Here to perform their latest single, Incomplete, are the Backstreet Boys.
Yeah! Everybody's taken advantage of the place and going on a ride before they do our show.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Didn't frighten any of you, did we?
Nah, but we made PG and Nick sit together.
So yeah. let's begin now. Odd. Together 12 years, and when did it begin?
Well, actually, we just celebrated 12 years. April 20th of 1993 was when we got together.
Uh-huh.
So, actually, I was in Lexington, Kentucky, and my cousin Kevin and I are first cousins, he called me April 19th, and I flew to Orlando April 20th, and it's been together ever since.
And that's where it started, in Orlando, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now, but we haven't heard too much about you or from you.
Yeah,
we
just thought that you guys broke up.
Yeah, I did.
I didn't.
No?
But what have you been up to? What have you been doing?
Well, we all took a well-needed break. We were a little fried after the last tour. We were kind of taking...
Did he say fried?
Fried.
Yeah. We're frying fried right now, too.
And we were just taking each other for granted. We were taking the business for granted. We just needed a well-deserved break. And during the break, Nick, I'll just go down the line. Nick was doing a solo tour and a solo album, as well as working on some acting and stuff. I was busy working on my sobriety, working on myself. I have a little over 2.5 years now sober.
That's good for that, baby. How you doing now?
I'm doing great. I'm doing
good.
Awesome. My life has changed for nothing but the better.
Great.
And I thank you for all your support. Thank you. Howie was we all call Howie Trump Jr. because he's making some really good investments in real estate lately, as well as working on a Spanglish album, solo album, as well as doing some acting.
Oh, that's great.
Kevin, as you know, was doing Broadway both on the West End in London as well as in New York. And he also just co-produced a soundtrack to an independent film that'll be coming out this summer called Rise, that David LaChapelle directed. And last but not least, Brian, he's a new father now of a 2.5-year-old little boy, Barry.
Yeah, we met the little baby about a year ago.
And he's also going to be releasing a pop gospel album this coming fall.
Wow. Oh, great. So you guys have been doing a lot.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
But here's the new CD coming out next month.
We're so proud of it.
And how long did it take to make this one?
This album actually took a lot longer than our past albums. I think we knew how critical it was to get into studio and make the best album of our careers. And we took about 1.5 years to do this.
No kidding, 1.5 months.
And, you know, music has changed and we realized that. But we just kind of wanted to go in there and do something different and new and fresh and something that we've all been proud of. You know, it kind of started off a little bit urban, a little R&B in the beginning. And then we got back together with Max Martin, our original producer. And now he's written like four songs on the record. And it's now turned into this kind of pop rock, more alongside the pop end, but it's great. We're very proud of it.
Did you hear one of the contestants on American Idol sing your song this week?
Yeah, actually. Yeah, my brother called me from Florida, since we're all now residing here in Los Angeles area, since we've been working on the album for the last year.
And
he called me up earlier, like about 3 hours earlier, and said, you gotta watch American Idol. They're actually incomplete's being sung.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, oh.
I was actually surprised. Like, I was surprised that Simon didn't say anything bad about it.
But, well, Simon's a big fan of yours. Yeah. We just asked him right here.
He's an awesome guy.
Well, how did Anthony do? Does it make you cringe when other people sing your song?
I haven't heard it, so I can't attest to that. Has anybody heard it?
I
heard
just it. Say it's definitely, I would, my hat's off to anybody, especially as a solo artist who tries to sing a song that we do five-part harmony.
Yeah, that would be
definitely a challenge.
It's a compliment, though, that they would pick your song in the first
place. Absolutely.
It's a beautiful song.
Anytime they do your song, it's a compliment. You're right. So now, you know, they're touring around the country in smaller clubs, and now you're going out on a big tour this summer, huh?
Yeah,
how did the little tour circuit go? I know you played in New York City. Irving Plaza?
Yes, we did two sold-out nights in Irving Plaza. And it actually, the small tour that we did was actually fabulous. The response was amazing. The fans are getting a little older, and we're also having the younger siblings. Sure.
We're
the fans
not getting older.
No, we're not getting older. Just none of us.
Make you feel good to know that, gee, they still remember you so well. And
it was great to reconnect with our fans, and that's the whole purpose of it, was to reconnect in a small atmosphere, in a small venue, just to get up and close. And it
does
was
it
great.
Just sort of get you back in shape, too, for those bigger arenas?
Yeah. Absolutely. Totally. Because in a smaller audience, you're actually more vulnerable, I feel like, than you are in a bigger audience.
Yeah, know what you mean.
We actually threw AJ in the audience.
Yeah,
AJ got the crowd.
Something we've never done before.
Oh, really?
It was awesome. A rock and roll group.
Tomorrow we've got your brother on, Nick. We've got Aaron Carter on tomorrow.
Yeah, Aaron's coming on tomorrow.
I'm sorry, I'm so far away.
Yeah, Aaron's going to come on tomorrow down in Florida.
Excellent.
Well, anyway, guys, it's great to have you back. It really is on CD.
Thank you.
Now, June 17th, 14th. Never Gone is the name of it. We thank you very much for being with us. Great to have you back. Thanks for making us the first show.
Thank you.
All right, Kelly's got those kids. She's going to talk to around the park in just a moment.
Tomorrow on Live from Walt Disney World in Florida, from the miniseries Revelations, actor Bill Pullman.
Our next guest is one of the most successful pop groups of all time. It has been 5 years since their last record, and fans worldwide are thrilled the wait is over. Here to perform their new hit, Incomplete, please welcome the Backstreet Boys.
Empty spaces fill me up with holes, distant faces with no place left to go. Without you within me, I can't find no rest. Where I'm going is anybody's guess. I try to go on like I never knew you. I'm awake, but my world is half asleep. I pray for this heart to be unbroken, but without you all I'm going to be incomplete. Voices tell me that I should care.
Took a well-needed break. We were touring pretty straight for about 8, almost 9 years. And after the last tour, we were all a little bit fried. There's a lot of negativity after that last tour. After 9/11 happened, I went to rehab. But while we were on the actual break, Nick was doing a solo album and a solo tour. Kevin did Broadway, both in New York and on the West End and London. Brian started a family. He's got a 2.5-year-old little boy named Bailey. He's a Backstreet dad.
Yes.
Howie, we all call Howie TJ for Trump Jr. because he's been getting involved with some real estate investments. And I was working on my sobriety and just
how
myself.
Long, you've been sober how long now?
About 2 years and 8 months.
Good
now.
For you.
My life has changed for the better. I love it.
Yeah. But, so you probably, I mean, seriously, I'm not even joking, you probably don't remember a lot of the tour.
I don't. I really don't.
Yeah, I mean, you weren't even enjoying your success.
I really wasn't. I was taking everything for granted. I really was. And now I can look back and that's that's in the past. Now everything I see and experience with these guys is new and fresh, and I can appreciate it and be very grateful and thankful for it. And I appreciate all the support from all the people.
That's great, yeah.
All fans, thank you.
I mean, it's amazing to be able to come back and be grateful for it.
And we're grateful that the fans have accepted us with open arms still. Yeah. It's amazing.
But this is, how long ago was this?
Eight or nine years ago.
This is how you started out.
Wow.
Yeah.
We're celebrating 12 years together. So, yeah, it's... Yeah. Some bad wardrobe there.
Yeah.
We're a hockey team there.
We dressed ourselves. Yeah.
That's the hockey team.
That's before Stylus. We used to get a lot of hockey jerseys.
But that's a good family portrait, because you saw those other ones. Somebody could have been crying in this. At least you're all smiling. The Backstreet Boys' new CD is called Never Gone. It hits stores June 14th. They're going to perform later in the show. And I've got some baby gifts for Brittany and Kevin. We come back. Don't go away. Here once again, the Backstreet Boys.
Yeah. Oh.
B-Rock.
You are my fire, the one desire. Believe when I say I want it.
People on 3,800 flights every day. American Airlines knows why you fly.